Hunting provides many levels of satisfaction, ranging from my enjoyment of being outdoors to the challenge of interacting with game species who have evolved to survive and elude predators such as me. And I also value a lot the protein that I can bring into my home.
We are conservationists. We are tools for this system to work, for animals and environments to thrive.
I'm very optimistic for hunting going forward, assuming that we continue to teach people the right way to do it.
Well, I've been hunting close to 50 years.
I started hunting with my father when I was a child. My grandfather taught him to hunt, and so my dad taught me to hunt. All three of us hunt together.
I have actually only hunted for 15 years. You have to make the sport safe, it has to be affordable, and it has to be accessible.
Hunters are very passionate about hunting. It's part of who they are, it's their lifestyle. So something as fundamental as what they're shooting, what they put in their firearm, is a very important component of the hunting experience. Up until about 10 years ago, I used pretty much whatever I could find on the shelf that was at the right price. Those were lead cord, copper jacketed bullets, typically from Remington, but other manufacturers as well. And I tried a variety of makes and designs. But I began paying attention to the consequences of our ammunition choice.
Lead is a toxin, and it's toxic at any dose. There are no organisms that are safe from lead. It is a universal toxin. There is no safe dosage of lead.
A hunter shoots an animal. The bullet passes through the animal, or it may go through the animal and then stop. If it's a lead core bullet, some fragments of that bullet are going to fly off and be deposited in the carcass. We know from x-rays that lead particles may go as far as 20 inches away from that wound channel into the edible portions of the animal.
As a new deer hunter, my first thing I overlooked was my choice of ammo. My first season out hunting, I was fortunate enough to harvest a deer. And while we were processing the deer in the front shoulder, I noticed all of the particles of lead. I didn't use that meat. I discarded it because I didn't feel comfortable consuming that.
So I was using lead bullets to hunt with. This particular one I shot a few years ago. These pieces, they were in the hind quarter in the stakes. I had shot the deer through the rib cage right above the heart. So that piece of copper and lead both traveled through that entire deer. This is about 92 grains remaining of a 165 grain bullet. This thing lost almost half of its complete mass in that animal. Now, I picked up and found these pieces, but where's the rest of it?
The most common route of exposure for wild animals is through hunter ammunition that is left in carcasses or in gut piles in the field. Scavengers, such as bald eagles, can find those carcasses or those gut piles and then consume lead. Bald eagles can also expose the young eaglets to lead in the nest. The symptoms of lead poisoning depend on the amount of lead that is ingested or inhaled. Wildlife can be brought into rehabilitation centers if they're found sick or dying. Some of those animals can be treated, but more often than not, they succumb to the lead poisoning.
So I use a copper projectile or bullet. I do the same when I'm hunting with either shotgun, muzzleloader, or with a rifle. Cost comparison is always the big thing. What I find is that because I'm using a better quality round, that I might use the same box of shells for 2 or 3 years. What every hunter strives to do is to harvest whatever they hunt ethically with one good, accurate shot. This sabot that I have here, which is a copper with a plastic tip, I can shoot hole in hole at 100 yards with consistency. I know that when I shoot this, it's not only going to hit where I aim it, but it's also going to cut through as it expands.
What is a challenge for a hunter trying to find copper ammunition is availability. Stores that carry ammunition will do special orders so you can get copper ammo if they don't have it. Some of the larger stores carry a good selection of copper ammo. But if you go to a local small shop, there's a good chance a week before the hunting season, you're not going to find copper ammo. So you got to be prepared. You've got to do your homework.
Making a decision that is both friendly to the environment as well as making sure that what you put in your freezer and harvest to eat for yourself and your family is safe is a major consideration, and at least it is for us, and I'm hopeful that it will be for other people as well.
The idea of using a non-lead alternative cycles back and plays into that legacy idea of hunting and passing the joy and the practice, the privilege down to future generations.